Sight,
an organic lens,
sight
that we view everything through.
Sight,
your eyes,
sight,
are one of the greatest processors,
sight,
that you
sight,
have.
Sight,
what you see, you
sight,
believe.
Sight,
but sometimes you can't believe what
sight,
you see.
Sight.
Don't take sight for granted.
Sight.
Look.
Sight.
Look around you.
Sight.
Look at the trees, sight, the stars.
Sight.
The passing cars.
Sight.
Look.
Sight.
Take it all in.
Sight.
Drink it up into your eyes.
Sight. Sight.
For sight.
Sight. Sight. Sight. Sight.
Is for viewing.
Sight.
Welcome sight, to everything
sight,
now.
Sight. 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 Sight.
Eyeball.
Sight.
Eyeball.
Sight.
Eyeball.
Look at the sights.
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 It's a bird. It's a plane. Welcome to the show! Thank you all for tuning in. I am Radic Al. I am your host, your spiritual guide, your art horcrux, your vessel. We'll be guiding you through this art journey tonight. Thank you all for joining us. On my right here, we have Spanx.YaBaby, half man, half website. He is the musician for the digital age. And of course, on my left, we have Russell, my beautiful, beautiful stepbrother. He produces the entire show for us. We couldn't do it without him. And I love him so much. I wish we were related by blood, but we aren't. I love you, Russell. You're great. If only my mother could have birthed you as well.
Well, that's not how it happened. Our parents met on a cruise, so. Sorry.
Anyway, thank you to everyone who's watching. I hope you're enjoying yourselves. Tonight's theme is obviously sight. This will all be about how we use our vision in different ways. You're watching me right now. I'm watching you, or at least a figment of you through the lens of this camera in front of me. And we're gonna go on a journey together. It's gonna be great. Couple things before we get started. We have a plug. There's a streaming service. Russell's been telling me about it, called Twitch. If you guys haven't been on it, you should get on it. It's apparently better for the show. It'll apparently help us support ourselves for the show and help us kind of sustain ourselves. So please sign up for Twitch. It's really easy. It's really free. And follow us. And if you're tuning in on Facebook, we still love you. Still tune in on Facebook. And yeah. So first things first, we plugged the video submissions last week. So I just want to check in on that. Russell, do we have any sort of video submissions?
I'm not sure yet. I'm going to go ahead and check the email, see if we've gotten anything so far.
Great.
And,
What does it say, Russell?
It seems like someone has used our email account to sign up for a Buffalo Wild Wings account. So,
Buffalo what?
Buffalo Wild Wings. They're a chain restaurant. It's like sports.
How'd they get our?
We did advertise the email.
Okay, so. Everyone, you can bring it back.
Okay.
Everyone, the email was to submit video submissions. Please do not sign us up for Buffalo Wild Wings or any sort of wing sort of business or any sort of that. Please submit your videos. In the comments, please tell us how you're feeling. How do you feel about the things you see? What's the favorite thing you saw today? Please say in the comments, and we'll give you a little shout out. All that fun stuff. Oh, okay. Do a little music, Spanx. Tommy saw a car crash today. What else did you guys see today? Taven saw a Korean preschool full of sweet kids. Tell me what you saw today, people. I want to know. Chris saw a chocolate birthday cake. Derek saw this dance move, and now you're about to see this one. Jake saw homework. Gross. Ryan saw Toto's grave today. I wonder how Dorothy feels about that. All right, well, keep telling us what you saw today. Right now, we are going to bring out our first guest. He is a virtual reality specialist. I believe he designs virtual reality experiences. He's going to show us a few of his VR experiences for the audience. Please welcome, what's his name?
His name is,
James Buffet?
James Buffet.
Please welcome James Buffet. James, come on over. Here you go. Come on in, James. There you go. Oh, that's good. Wait, 1 second.
It's gonna be a great show. I'm so excited. Thank you.
Right here.
Thank you, Al, for having me.
Yeah.
Thank you, Russell, for sending me that email. I'm real excited to show you guys the wonders of VR, the virtual world. I got a couple of virtual experiences that I've been working on. The VR world is a scary and mysterious place, but it doesn't have to be. I've created a series of virtual experiences that will help you acclimate to the virtual world in a way that's fun and you'll learn things too.
Great. So I guess you have a VR experience that you're going to show us?
Yeah, I've got a couple of experiences that I've been developing for the past few months. Currently, I'm in my home space where sort of I've got my whole layout. My magazines are over here, and my cooking utensils are over here. You won't be able to see that at home right now, but soon I'll be switching over so that you can be a part of the virtual experience with me. So if we could just, Russell, if you could set that up for me.
Yeah, I'm opening up your file right
open
about
up
now.
The,
thank you. All right, thank you, James. And I believe you have to be seated for this one?
Yeah, for the first one.
Just back up. No, a little bit further. No, a little bit further back.
You got it?
And, oh, there you go.
Great.
Okay.
So why don't you tell us a little bit about this?
Great.
Okay. So I think I got it ready. Are we good to...
Okay. You want to...
Is the feed live?
Oh, almost.
Great.
And, okay.
All right, I received
Here it.
Here it is. And we're ready to go. And, oh, wow.
So, yeah. You can see here, this is a virtual experience of a car wash. As you can see, my hands are being tracked in real time. You can reach out
That's really
and explore
impressive.
The space.
Wow.
It's a full 360 panorama, so as you can see, I can touch the roof here. The suds are coming in picture-perfect clarity.
This is really incredible quality.
There's different textures you can feel on the steering wheel. You're completely able to move the environment. It's a totally tactile experience. Things open up. They close. You can flip through your CDs. Got a selection here, my favorite tunes. But really, this experience is just meant to show you sort of some of the amazing developments we've taken in the virtual world. Over here, you're going to be able to see, I'm going to open up my grocery bag here, just show you some of the things that I've been shopping for. So what do we got in here? It looks like, there it is. The cool, refreshing taste.
Huh.
Of a Corona. That you can see here, your hand goes right in, it can fit right into there.
Okay.
It's totally tactile. You
can
really just reach out and grab it, and look at that. Look at the textures.
Let's stop that. James, we actually can't do commercials or any sort of advertisements on the show.
Oh, of course. This isn't a commercial. This is just sort of an exploration of reality, a sort of slice of life American experience that I feel like anybody can relate to. So any advertisement sort of vibe is totally unintentional.
Yeah, it seemed that you were just featuring Corona heavily. It seemed like that was a centerpiece of this VR experience. We just want to make sure that we're not doing any commercials. You know, that could get us banned. It could really lower our credibility in the underground art world. We don't want to do that for...
We're three episodes deep.
Totally agree, 100%. Look, I've got some other experiences that I'd love to show you. I just got to get back into the computer room, make a couple of small tweaks, and I'm really excited to show you what's coming up next. I think you're really going to like it.
Okay, great. Thanks, James. Here, let me help you up. Give it up for James Buffet, guys. Virtual reality experience. Yeah, here. Come on over. Come on over here, James. There you go. Right, you're almost there. You're so close. There you go, James. Give it up for James again. We do not support Corona or any big business! Oh, sorry guys, I got a little heated. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. That was pretty cool up until that last part, but that's how it works. So, big fan of virtual reality. It's close to regular reality without a lot of the danger, stuff like that. So great. We'll check back in with James in a little while and see what other VR experiences that he has. All right. Coming up next, we have a little audience participation game. I know how much you guys like that. It's involving vision. It is an eye test. So basically how this will work is we will give you a picture on the screen. It will be blurry. You will have to tell us in the comments what you think that picture is. You will guess in the comments. I will let you know if you're right or wrong. If you get it right, then we will hang up your picture on the Wall of Fame, either over there or over there. The Wall of Fame hasn't been started yet, but we'll hang your picture on the Wall of Fame. You'll get up here, and you'll be a part of everything now forever. How this works, we'll show the picture, it'll be blurry. If it's too hard for you, we'll slowly unblur the picture until it's better for you to see and someone guesses correctly. So, I think we're ready for our first image, Russell.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, the first image right here.
All right. Can anybody take a guess at what this is? Any guesses?
We got ice cream from Tommy.
Ice cream? It is not ice cream. Clorox wipes? No. Minion? No. Prescription pill bottle? No. Candy rope? No. You're getting closer, Tommy. Lysol wipes? No. All right, let's unblur the photo a little bit. What about now? What do you see floating next to me?
It's a good guess, Jake, but no.
Circus peanuts, no, that is not correct. Hey, Chris Chalakian! Let's show that picture. It is Gushers! Chris, you are the winner! You'll have your picture up on the Hall of Fame if you so choose. It is optional, but if you so choose, you'll have your picture up on the Wall of Fame. Because you guessed Gushers. Fantastic. All right, now we have our second image.
Right, 1 second.
Russell is pulling up our second image. Don't worry, there could be multiple winners.
Okay, let's do it. Next image. I'm
going to get off to the side here. What is this blurry object? What do we got here? It's kind of hard to see. Tommy Regan. No, the show is not sponsored by Gushers, Tommy. I thought that would be fun. Oh. A picture of a pig's face, no. Little crab, no.
Crab guesses.
Pink crabs, no.
Yeah.
These are great guesses. How about we unblur it for them?
Sure.
Toby Bunny, no.
Okay.
Energizer Bunny, no. Ooh, what is it now? What is it? What is it? You can say it first. The red man.
Uh-oh.
Oh, we're getting close. Hey! We got a winner! Show it! It is Santa Paven! You are a winner! Congratulations, Paven. You will get up on the Hall of Fame as well. Optional, of course. All right, now our last image. You bring it up, Russell. All right, Who is this? That's a clue. Who is this? Who is this blurry image of? Steven has opted in for the award. Great.
It not Bert, Jake. Sorry.
It's not Bert. Guy from King of the Hill? No. It is actually a real person. A man. That's close, Derek.
Good guess.
A man. James Buffet? No.
Context clues? Good, but
Mr. Peanut? No. As long as that's a good guess. I can kind of see Mr. Peanut in there. What is this viscous form right here? Doctor Who? No. Let's unblur it a bit for them, shall we? Who is this? Who is this? Who is this man? He looks famous. He's in one of those, in front of one of those fancy, bunch of things. Mark Zuckerberg? No.
They're called step and repeat.
Mike? It's not Mike.
Tom from MySpace.
Any other guesses? 5-0? No. Handsome?
Possibly.
John Mayer? No. I can see that. I can see that. Any other guesses? Let's unblur it one more time. Who is this?
Who is this?
Can anyone name who this man is? Can anyone name this person? No, not Jesse Eisenberg. Can anyone name this celebrity? Anyone know who this celebrity is? It's a famous actor.
He's been in some movies, guys. Come on.
He's in the likes of Saving Private Ryan. Come on.
He was in Battlefield Earth, the Scientology movie.
Let's reveal it.
Okay.
Yeah. It is Barry Pepper, Canadian actor. There it is, Barry Pepper. Well, congrats to Chris. Congrats to Paven. You are our two winners. You'll go up on the Hall of Fame, Wall of Fame, right up either over here or over here. The at Kappa from Twitch does not know who Barry Pepper is. Welcome at Kappa to our stream. Look at that work. Look at all that he's done. Barry, 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 Pepper, Barry, Pepper, Barry, Pepper, Barry, Pepper, Barry, Pepper, Barry, Pepper, Barry, Pepper. Okay. Our next segment is a new segment. I'm not even going to introduce it. I'm just going to let Russell roll the bumper, and we'll check out this new segment from one of our close friends.
As everyone knows, rainbows usually have a treasure at the end. Let's follow this one and see if we can find the pot of gold.
Ah, there it I suppose you've come to claim me treasure.
Well, we'd like to see the gold first.
Nathan, there's better than gold in here.
Spanx made that intro. That was great, Spanx. That was a great intro. So this is a segment called Spanx Picks. This is a segment where Spanx will bring something in, either physically or from the internet, or something that he's found over the last week that he's really admired and wants to share with everyone. And I figure we can give him a chance. We all love Spanx, and you know, we wanna see what he's got. What do you got, Spanx? What do you got for us? Is it a website? Is a oh, looks like it's something physical. What do you got? What is that, Spanx? Is that a picture of who is that? Is that a picture of a woman? Is that a specific person? It's a nice sweater. She looks like she's from a different time period. Where'd you find this? Spanx, why'd you choose to show this to all of our peers? This is a, I don't know who that is. She's kind of attractive, yeah. She's got nice sunglasses on. Cool, thanks, Spanx. That's great. Everyone give it up for Spanx. Those Spanx picks. This segment is definitely coming back. All right. Oh. Spanx, how about we do a little palate cleanser? Do a little bit of music. How are we feeling, guys? Anybody who's watching? Add a tap out.
Sound off in the chat, folks.
Tell us what you saw today. Anybody else? Tell us what you saw today. We want to utilize our vision. We want to express the things that we've seen. We want to remember them. We want to cherish them. Russell, what did you see today?
I saw some triplets in the park.
You saw triplets?
Yeah, playing with their mother. It was nice. I was on my lunch break.
Oh. Yeah. Great.
It was pretty nice.
Well, Russell saw triplets. Oh, Derek saw a homeless guy outside the Vermont Beverly Station. I assume that's a specific train station. Fantastic. Jake saw a farmer market. All right. Thank you, Spanx. You're really great. The picture was something else. All right, so it looks like we're going to check back in with our good friend James Buffet to see if he's got another virtual reality experience to show us. See if he's ready. James, are you ready? Oh, there you are. Come on out, James. Come on out. There you go. Right out here. There you go. Oh, oh. Oh. Oh, no, here. You okay?
Just a glitch.
Does it glitch a lot?
Mm-hmm. Oh, no. We're still working out some of the kinks in the workflow, but everything's running smooth. Really excited. We got some great new experiences for you to check out. And just like VR is interactive, this is interactive, and so pick the experience that you want to have.
Yeah, I have an overlay here.
Oh, the audience will get to pick the experience.
Yeah.
It's totally interactive, and you're the judge. Oh, it's totally interactive, and you're the judge.
Okay.
You can choose which experience you want to do.
Great.
From the
like
selection
here.
Right here.
Oh, so it looks like we got dishes. Is that like washing the dishes?
That's a virtual experience of washing your dishes.
Great. And then we have drums, it looks like. What's that like?
For the musically inclined, a drum set for you to play.
Okay.
And the Declaration of Independence, what is that?
For you history buffs at home, this experience will get a little slice of the Founding Fathers.
Wow, that's interesting. Okay, well, vote for your experience you want to see. It looks like we got 3 votes for Declaration of Independence. Please keep your votes in. Will this be a seated, standing? I guess it depends.
This is a which experience is the audience selecting?
Our votes are still coming in.
Yeah.
We got 3 for Declaration of Independence. We're still waiting on the votes to come in. Turn. There you go. How about you tell us, while we're waiting for the votes to come in, how about you tell us about what does a glitch look like in the virtual world?
So with any sort of new technology, there's going to be bugs. Me and my team are doing our best to make sure that we minimize those experiences. But sometimes when you're in one of the virtual experiences, you might see something that you weren't expecting. So like an item or a tangible asset may appear inside of the experience that you just weren't expecting to be there, something like that. But don't worry, we're getting those kinks. We're gonna get those kinks kinked right out.
Great, awesome. Well, it looks like it's unanimous. We are going with the Declaration of Independence.
Oh, one of my favorites.
Okay, great. Well, you need to be seated.
For this one, this is a standing experience.
Oh, okay, great. So we'll just
position you. Perfect.
Okay. Great. Here's a good start.
Okay.
All right.
And let's load that up.
All right, I'm receiving your feed, and we're in now.
Great. So as
come on, Hancock. We've been talking about this for the past week. You just read it and sign. Don't even read it, just sign it.
I want to say commerce.
By Jove, he's done it! We are a free nation!
Hear, hear!
Let us celebrate with Corona!
What?
Find your
okay,
beach!
Come on.
Find your beach!
What the hell? God damn it.
Wait, what? What was... James, what was another...
Looks like we're... don't sweat it. It looks just like minor technical. Just a little glitch. But we're gonna have our boys back in the lab take a look at that. Nothing to worry about. Just a small little tweak.
James, those were our founding fathers after signing the Declaration of Independence that all clinked Coronas together.
Yep. And I'd just like to point out how real and it felt like you were in the room.
It doesn't matter.
Part of the experience is and look at the and did you see the glossy finish on that table? And all the textures. And
James.
I was distracted.
Why don't you take a seat? James, let's take a seat real quick.
Great.
You can back up. Back up. Keep backing up. Oh, there you go. Plop yourself down right there. Okay, James. I want to have a little heart-to-heart with you. I'm right here. Yeah. James. Do you have a problem?
What we do is we find solutions.
James, do you have a problem with drinking Corona specifically?
I don't have a problem with drinking Coronas right now. No, not at the moment.
Right now you're in virtual reality. It's just weird. It keeps popping up
In this universe, I don't have any problems, and in fact, I have the opposite of problems because in the virtual world, it's anything is possible.
James,
in the virtual
James,
world,
Why do coronas keep appearing in your virtual reality experiences?
That's just a glitch. The boys back in the computer are gonna.
James, what's going on?
Who are the boys?
The boys. Boys back at the lab are just fixing those kinks, getting those bug report sent out. Just a little glitch in the matrix is all. But don't let that scare you away from the beautiful wild world of virtual reality.
James, you showed up in a van alone. I don't know who this team you're talking about is.
That's a company car.
If you have a
that's a company car.
If you have an issue, you can tell us. We're
it's a safe space.
It's a safe space. And
speaking of safe spaces, part of the beauty of the virtual world is anything can be your space. I live in a castle in a French chateau. I live in a French chateau in my virtual world.
Okay. All right, James, thank you so much. Maybe we'll tune in again. Oh, yeah, there you go. Maybe we'll tune in again to see if you...
Thank you.
Yeah, to see if you have any other experience. Oh, watch the light there. You're good, yeah. Oh, right over here. Oh, that's a little this way.
Great.
You're almost there. You're so close. There you go, James. Everyone give it up for James Buffet. Wow, what a great guy, that guy. Whew. Oh, how are you feeling, Russell?
Fine. I just really worried about the flagging of, the product placement.
Me too, yes. Yes, me too. I don't want to promote any sort of beer.
The VR looks great.
No, it's really...
The technology's
incredible.
Yeah,
it's really immersive. It really had me fooled up until...
Sure.
The part where they pulled
cold Coronas.
Cold beer out
exactly.
of there.
Yeah, they did not do that in 1776?
Yeah. They said here, and then they slammed the
yeah.
beers onto the table.
Also, I think I heard that he was playing John Hancock.
Interesting.
So,
They keep saying Find Your Beach. Is that...
I don't know. We have some suggestions. Chris says, let's play Kiss Killer Keep with James's VR mask.
All right.
It's very expensive equipment.
Let's be, you know.
And over on Twitch,
nice about this.
We got Tossin' Lover saying, what in God's name is this?
What in God's name is this? Welcome, Tossin' Lover. This is Everything Now, the show where we're bringing underground art right into your eyeballs. The Netflix, the performance art, all of these things right to your phone, tablet, computer. We're all here for you. We're doing live performances. I'm glad you can join us. And then we also have Yoko Mendez saying, hey, hello, Yoko. If anyone on Twitch, tell us anything that you've seen today.
With your own eyes.
With your own eyes. Anything out in the world that you've seen that's interesting, please tell us. We'll give you a shout out. And, we're glad that you're all here experiencing this with us. And, it's just really great to be here together. All right, Russell.
Okay.
So it looks like now we're going to take another dip in the mainstream.
Yeah.
Take a swim in the mainstream. Take a swim in the mainstream.
All right, if you know this, if you saw this segment last week, it is where we take a piece of art or substance from the mainstream psyche, something that a lot of people seem to love, a lot of things that have floated into the group mind, and we bring it back down underground, and we contextualize it in our underground forms of art. Last week we did a Demi Lovato song, and I read beat poetry. And this week we have something special for you. I don't really want to give it any introduction. I just want to play the track. So
okay.
Russell?
Sure.
If you will?
Yeah.
Please, please play it.
To see the hang-ups we have today.
Next verse, this verse, watch this am shit, poopy di scoop di wdopia hoop, wdopia hoop di scoop di poop, poop di scoop di wdopia hoop, wdopia hoop di scoop, wdopia hoop poop, poop di wdopia hoop scoop, poop, poop, scoop di wdopia hoop, wdopia hoop di scoop, wdopia hoop di scoop, poop.
All right. Thank you. That was, a rendition of Lift Yourself, performed by an Italian computer. Hope you enjoyed that. I think you know what this segment is. It is Kiss, Kill, or Keep. This is the segment where we bring in a piece of art, and you will vote whether to kiss, kill, or keep the art. Kissing the art, I will kiss the art. Kill it, I will destroy it live in front of you, and keep it, we will put it on the set, and keep it on the set for the rest of everything now. Right here, we have a great piece of art. If you would look, it is a ceramic penguin. He looks to be a little chubby. He's waddling around, little profile view. The chubby little glass penguin. It's up to you whether to kiss, kill, or keep it.
Aww.
So we'll leave it open and let's get some music.
Jen, at home, we appreciate your enthusiasm. Eat has not been established as one of the tenets of the game, but all run it by Al. Okay, come on, Jen. Okay.
All right, I think we got enough votes in. Guys, it looks like we all voted to kiss. And I'm proud of you. For the first time we did this, I thought that we were just a destructive bunch, but looks like we do have some love in our hearts. So now I will kiss this beautiful penguin. Hey, I just want to let you know that I had a really good time tonight. Chili's was a great call. You ate those ribs so fast, it was crazy. Those margaritas were great, I pray, so. You're great. You're a great penguin, you know? It's hard to meet people these days, you know? It's like either online or on an app. But it's crazy how I just saw you in Express Menswear folding pants. And I was like, can I get a room? And you were like, yeah. And here we are. I know this is a first date, but I was just wondering, could I kiss you? Okay. I'll text you later. Okay, bye. All right, that was Kiss Killer Keep. Guys, it's been a great show. We've seen so many things together. Wow, virtual reality experiences, a picture of a woman that nobody knows, and we saw love, even if it was just a little taste. So next up, we have another guest. This person uses vision in a different sense, I would say. Is able to see beyond our normal reaches of vision, able to see things that exist outside of our present conception of space and time, into future, into past, into different moments, different tap into different types of vision that we are not used to. And I'm happy to introduce our guest. I'm sorry, I'm so bad with names, Russell. You need to remind me of the name.
Zevin Lo Siento.
All right, everyone, welcome, Zevin Lo Siento. Welcome to the show. Welcome to Everything Now.
Hello, Everything Now. Oh, hello, everybody. My name is Zevin. I'm thrilled to be in America. I'm thrilled to be on your show. So let's
get into this.
Great.
Tell us a little bit about yourself. You can take a seat if you want. Or...
Sure.
So I guess you can go into just go in and tell us a little bit about yourself, what you do. We'd love to hear about it.
I'd love to. I'd love to. I was born in Northern Europe, and I traveled a lot. My mother was also a traveling psychic, and my father was murdered very early, so we moved a lot. It was a very exciting childhood, and being a psychic is no easy task, contrary to popular belief. But I'm here to talk about something a little specific, which is a new business venture of mine. My late cousin Elon Musk has inspired me to kind of just express myself financially and entrepreneurially. So I have some gifts for everything now, some new inventions.
Great.
I mean, what, just take it in.
What is that?
These are new Zevin's paper towels. They're available on Amazon if you search Zevin's Things. They look like normal paper towels, but they are USB compatible. They have Bluetooth connector, and they can clean up any mess just with one little sheet. So here we go. We'll do a little taste test. Let me have your hand, please. Your hand, please. He's so nervous. I've never been around such a beautiful man like this.
Yeah, I just didn't expect. I thought we were. It's like some sort of palm reading?
Oh, wow. It's very rude to assume that the psychic can just do those things. It's very dance monkey dance. So, no, this is just I'm cleaning your hand. It's very dirty.
Oh, sorry. I didn't want to assume anything. Thank you for cleaning my.
But while I'm here, I must say your childhood trauma with your father must have been very difficult to deal with. It's very loud. Your blood cells are yelling at me. I can hear them now. They're saying to me, you know, when you were on the playground in the fourth grade, it must have been tough to have all the boys throw fecal matter at you.
Well, we don't have to say that on this show.
You know, when you're this talented, it's hard to not tell the truth. Am I right? Everything now, but there's more where that came from. We have patented sponge set. And Zevin's new spray, they're also available on Amazon, limited time offer, together for $19.99. And these are fabulous. These are USB and Bluetooth compatible, and they are safe for dog use. They are safe to use when you're camping. They're safe for anything. And your friend over here, Russell, hey, hello, handsome. Let me have your hand and show a demonstration to the audience at home.
Oh, okay,
Oh no. Oh wow. You are so sick. Oh my god. You know.
I mean, I have a cough.
No, you don't. You have a rash, yeah? Left eye, yeah? It's going to be.
I'm sorry. I thought you were supposed to come on to do psychic readings. I didn't know you were coming on to sell your.
You're being very rude.
It hurts now.
I come on this show. To sell my things, to see America, and I'm very thrilled to be here, but if you just expect me to do some dog and pony show, that's very rude, and you have to reconsider your kindness.
Okay. I'm sorry.
You have a girlfriend? Your girlfriend, tall, pretty, beautiful, yeah? She is going to get very, 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 very sick very soon. You need to make sure that the airbags in your car are fixed properly, okay? You wanted fortune. I gave you fortune, yeah?
Jesus.
You wanted fortune? You want good fortune, bad fortune, real fortune? What do you want, sweet Radic L? Insulting these products I bring on your show so kind of me.
Now my left eye kind of hurts.
Russell.
What?
Russell over there, stepbrother of Al. Remember that time that you were swimming in the community pool? Yes, because I see it now. All the other kids, they tried to drown you. They tried to pull you to the bottom. And you almost died. Radic Al! Your father never loved you. Your mother just tried her hardest. Spanx, you're going to go on to make big fortune. Nobel Prize. Pulitzer winning. Academy Awards. Beautiful wife. Beautiful, beautiful wife. Now look. Give me your hand. We're going to do one final demonstration where we're going to show how to get a new stain off of bad hand. I'm just going to do a quick spray. And we're going to use the sponge.
This just feels like Windex. sorry. Do the sponge head just.
Feel like Windex?
No, it feels very clean.
Yeah! Feels clean, right?
Yeah, it feels good. Listen, you know what? No. You know what? I invited you on the show because you said you were a psychic and that you were gonna read tell us our futures or something and give a good presentation for our audience and you're not doing that. You're just selling your stupid kitchen supplies and
you know nothing. You know nothing about the future. You know nothing about the universe. You know nothing about space. You and your stupid, feeble human body have no idea what telekinesis can do and what it can be. Your stupid show will be over by the end of the night. I own the internet. I own viewership. I am Zevin, dangerous overlord. To cross me is a large mistake, and you and your feeble human fortune have no idea what you've done. You have no idea what I can do, and if I were you, I would get away very quickly. Spanx, enjoy your beautiful wife. She has large breasts and great attitude, good professional attitude, Russell. Good luck with the rash. It will take over your entire body. And Radic Al, you of all, your doom is impending.
Let me see if I can get the lights back on. One second.
Yeah, if anyone has any information about Zevin Lo Siento, please send us an email.
That was horrible. Sorry about that, guys.
God damn it.
I guess we got more than what we bargained for with that one. And me and my father are great. We have a great relationship. I don't know why they said that, but I'm great. Oh, hey, James.
Hey.
Hey, where'd you? I didn't see you even popped up there. I'm over here. Great.
Hey.
Okay. Do you have a last experience that you'd like to show the audience?
I've been tinkering with the boys back in the lab, and we're really honing in on an experience, but I'm not sure if it's just quite ready for the public yet, so I don't think we have anything else for today, unfortunately.
Come on, James. You can show it to us. It doesn't have to be finished, or...
The thing is, it's a prototype. Prototypical experience that scans your brain and puts you in your Zen place, in your beach, so to speak. It'll help you find your beach. It'll help you get to the place inside your head that is Zen and full of happiness.
Great. Well, I'd love to see it. Let's just do it. Let's just play it.
I'm not sure if it's quite ready. It's not.
I have the feed. Should I cut to it?
No.
Oh, yeah. The feed. It's going right now.
Yeah.
I'm not
okay.
Sure if we should cut to the feed just right.
All right. I'm cutting to it now.
Let's cut to it.
Okay. Well, as you can see here, we run into a minor glitch, just a small technical glitch. But look at the beautiful textures on those bottles. Really glistening. It's like you're really there. Oh, okay. And you can see right there. All right,
James. Thank you so much, James. Yep, the exit. Oh, just stand up here. Yeah, the exit is right over here. Let's have a little playout music for James here. Yeah, James.
Thank you.
No, thank you, James. You really were great. Great. Yep. Oh, you're so close. You're so close. Okay. We do not associate with Corona or any brand or any beer. James, guys, it's been a great show. We've seen sights in so many different ways, ways I've never thought I'd see, things I never thought I'd see, people, experiences, visions. Oh, let's give it up. That's the end of our show. Thank you all for coming out. Again, my name's Radical. Thank you for tuning in. On my right, I have Spanks, our most talented musician. On the left, Russell, producer of the whole show. I love him so much. I wish he was my real brother. Guys, thank you so much. I hope you go out and see the world. I hope you love it. I hope you do everything you want to do. Please tune in next week. We have a very special experience for you. Everything now, video submissions at everythingnow.yeahbaby@gmail.com. Please don't subscribe us to any wings or anything like that. Let's play that music. Pump it louder, Spanx. I want to hear the music. Look at the people around you. Look at your friends and your family when you're at dinner with them. Look them in the eyes. Make sure that you see them and that they see you. Make sure you look around. You stop to look around. Just don't look at your phone. Just don't look at your screen. Actually look around. I mean, we only have one life to live. There's a limited amount of things you can see. We need to see everything we can while we still can. We gotta sight. We gotta see it. We gotta see it. I love you so much. You guys have been great. You guys have been so great. Oh, join me in seeing.